give thanksgiving and we praise. Amen. Let's come into his house today with praise. Would you stand to your feet? So good to see each and every one of you here today in the house of the Lord. Beautiful day outside. Amen. The sun's shining bright. The S-U-N's shining out there. The S-O-N is shining in here today. Praise God. Everybody looks wonderful. Look over at your neighbor and say, man, you're looking good today. Praise God. And just got a few announcements that I want to make before we get rolling here real good so everybody listen up. We got next week, we got it on the screen, February the 26th. Rick Strickland will be here with us, ministering song. Those of you that have been with him before, you know what a ministry he has. Just like the dad said last week, he'll have you laughing and crying and worshiping, and you'll just really enjoy his ministry. And so invite some people. Some people may not ever come to church because they come to church and hear some preaching. But some may say, you say, hey, we're going to have a singing. They may come in and the Spirit of God get dealing with their hearts because he will sing the gospel message and preach to them a little bit too. You will not be disappointed. And so just come and be sure to be here next week for that. And then also I have an exciting announcement to make. We'll be having a wedding shower here real soon. Amen. Praise the Lord. Micah. Our Micah is getting married soon. And this, Jill, this doesn't have a date on it. What's the date of it? April 1st is the shower, okay? And so everybody write that down, put it in your calendar. April 1st, be having a shower. Don't be taking a shower, but we'll be having a shower, and giving a shower, stowing gifts for Micah and Dustin. Amen, looking forward to this next step in their life. I know they're excited and we are excited. So we'll just be praying for them. But remember, April 1st, the shower for Micah and Dustin, okay? Praise God.
Jason,
yes, ma'am.
I'll be up that front door handing these out at the end of church. So every lady, be sure and come by and get one from me.
Yes, there you go. Jill will be at the door and the service. Amen. With a card and a check for them. Praise God. Praise the Lord. Do you love the Lord today? Praise so many, so good to have visitors with us. Like Dan and Jim, is that right? Praise the Lord. And we have Chris and Doug. Chris and Doug, I'm sorry. Chris and Doug here with us this morning for the first time. Praise the Lord. So glad to have you here today. And then anymore, we've got Ted Bloomberg here with us this morning. So we're glad he's bringing the virus to the past. And, it's so good to see him come in this morning. Just great, exciting things happening in the presence of the Lord today. Praise God. Amen. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Good to see Junior back with us. Answer to our prayer. Able to walk in here this morning. And he's walking slow, but he's walking. Praise God, he's moving. And I told him, and I'm just thankful. Amen. Just every step he takes, I believe God's going to just do a work, whether it comes through the hands of the doctor or whether it comes through his healing power that he can do in just a moment. God's able, amen, to do all those things. We believe him for that. Need to continue to pray for Jim, Bernice Franklin, and Sister Irene, Brother Ben Bishop. God will just continue to touch Brother Rick King. Amen. He really, I know his heart. And I know how he's missing being here and how we're missing him. I hope he's watching this morning. If you are, Rick, we miss you. We're praying for you. And we're just believing God to bring you back here real soon. And God's able to do that. And God will. Praise the Lord. Do you have a need today that only got Brother Steve Howe? Continue to meet Brother Steve. I mean, how's Steve doing? Is he doing okay? Praise the Lord. He's hanging in. Amen. God's going to continue to strengthen him. Bring him all the way out of this. Amen. And praise God. Let's go before the Lord in prayer. Can we do that? Just lift your hand if you have a need. Amen. Just look around at those beside you and say, hey, I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. There's power in agreement. anything any of us would agree, as we agree, touching anything the Bible says, it shall be done. Praise God. Father, we come before your mighty presence today. And we thank you, God. We praise you, God. We exalt you here today, God. We love you. And God, I know that you're able to do exceedingly abundantly above all we can ask or even think. God, you're an awesome God. God, you heard the needs of your people. You see us, God. You see us right where we are. And we praise you. We thank you, God, today that you're meeting these needs. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, God, for your goodness. Thank you, God, that by your stripes we are healed in the name of Jesus. In that name that's above every name. Praise God. The name of Jesus. Praise God. Amen and amen. Let's rejoice in the Lord. Remain standing. Amen. Let's praise him today. Magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. Praise God.
Praise God.
Welcome, Holy Spirit. We'll be right back.
worthy of it all. Praise God. He'll heal you right where you stand. You don't need anybody to lay hands on you. You don't need nobody to touch you. Praise God. The Spirit of the Lord is here. And if you'll just lift up your hands to Him and look towards Him, praise God, just like the psalmist said, I'm going to lift up my eyes. I'm going to get my eyes off of the here and now and what I feel and what kind of week I've had. And I'm going to get my eyes elevated just a little bit. I'm going to get my eyes on Jesus. Praise God. I'm going to get my eyes looking to the hills from which comes my help. My help comes from the Lord. Praise God. He's here to touch you. He's here to meet your need today. Praise God. Praise God. How many is excited about God and what He's doing throughout the land today? Praise God. It's so exciting to see what's going on up in Wellmore, I believe, Kentucky, and at Asbury University. God has just settled in that place. It's breaking out into Lee University in Cleveland, Tennessee. Many other universities also are experiencing revival, experiencing a move of God. I've got a little video I want to show you right before we take up our offering. I want you to watch this young man's testimony in Asbury, and just he touched my heart with this, and I believe it will touch yours too. Amen. Listen to the passion in his voice. Praise God.
In our city, we've been learning about revival, but I've never seen it. I didn't even know it was real. I'm like, I'm just sitting in class and they're telling us all these stories on college campuses and then going across the nation. And we're like, when is this going to happen? And then they lock you in a prayer room and you're just like, hey, you gotta ask for it. And you're just sitting there like, God, I'm asking. What does it look like? And then all of a sudden, my friend Jaden says, dude, I think Jesus just localized himself and just sat his throne in the room. How could we not drive 6.5 hours from this? And it's completely silent. I'm like, is this revival, God? And we walked upstairs and we're kind of nervous. We're like kind of shaking already. We didn't get any sleep. Just their terrible road trip partners. They both fell asleep. I drove most of them away. But besides that, we go upstairs and there's people like sleeping. And we're like, so this revival, no. Cool, this is awesome. And then the chapel starts and immediately we just see people flooding in. And God said, revival isn't hype. It's ordinary people who are hungry. It's ordinary people who are hungry. And He said, James, I'm gonna need you to go to the altar. And I'm like, I don't wanna go to the altar. And He's like, go to the altar. And I go to the altar and worship starts. And He's like, this is revival. Look left. And I look left. And there's this young college woman getting prayed over by an older woman. And He says, look right. And then there's this young guy praying over an older guy. And He says, look behind you. And everyone's just raising their hands. And He said, Gage, this is revival. It isn't hot. It's ordinary people crying out for a move of God in our generation. And I'm here to talk to everyone in this room who is hungry. What an honor. What an honor it is to be here. Revival's real. It isn't just a story you've heard about. It's come. And it's not just come here today, but it's about to spread out to the nation. I just gave my life a year and a half ago to Christ, and it has been the greatest thing I have ever done. I left everything, and I'm here to talk to every young person in this room. Forget the job, forget the girl.
Remembers, amen, when God touched you, man, you felt like that. Amen, you felt like that. What a feeling that is to be touched by God. And listen, He's not through. And God's not through. What God started in you is only the beginning. And what God's fixing to do across this country and at the Tri-Cities Church of God, Amen. What he's about to do, what he's doing already, but what he's about to do, amen, it's going to make your head spin. Amen. One translation of the Bible says that, that he's going to move so fast that you're going to sit back and your head's going to spin. And my God, look what the Lord is doing. Praise God. Hallelujah. I'm excited to be a part of it. We're so fortunate that God chose. He could have chose you to be alive at any time. But he chose you to be alive and right now to experience what we're about to experience in this country. Amen. Praise God for the goodness of God. Amen. Let's just remain, continue worshiping God with our giving today. Amen. God loves a cheerful giver. Amen. So get excited about it. Amen. Turn to your neighbor and say, smile. It's okay. Amen. Praise the Lord. God bless you. Amen. Your heart's beating this morning. Amen. You're able to move. You're able to walk around. Amen. God's doing a great thing. Praise God. So good to see Susie here with us today. Amen. Daniel's doing well. Amen. Come through open heart surgery this week. He's already home, right? Come home Friday night. Amen. Praise God. It's amazing, isn't it? It's amazing. God's answering prayers. God's a good God. Come on and worship him this morning with your giving. Praise the Lord.
for the broken and afraid. This is for those who are hurting. Hope and help is on the way.
Praise God. The last few weeks, I know the guy that a few weeks ago I preached out of Joshua said, get ready, get prepared, that God is getting ready to move us, getting ready to take us somewhere that we've now a journey we've never been before. I believe that's what we're going to see in these last days. Don't get your eyes expecting things to be like they've always been. Like church is going to be like it was when you received and you had a miracle in your life and the way everything was all set up. It may not look like that this go around. I believe it may look different. I believe the generation that's coming in that we're going to see saved, they're definitely not going to look like that we think they should. You know, a lot of times we get in our mindsets that if you look a certain way, you know, maybe you need to. But listen, God, this is a radical generation. And they're going to be radical for Jesus. And they're just looking for an answer. And we're sitting here today with that answer. We have that answer. And praise God, they're finding it all over. And it's amazing what God and how He's doing this move with the young generation, with this young group of people. And if you notice, if you're kind of a little bit keen in spiritual things and can see that, we can see the last 3 years when COVID started and we see churches are getting started back and people are coming in. There's a missing group here. If you look around just a little bit and kind of look and see who's missing. And you'll see that young group, they're not here this morning. And I don't want you to think that the Tri-Cities Church of God is the only group that's like that. You talk to pastors all over the country and they're all experiencing the same thing. And it's because the enemy is afraid of this generation and he's attacked this generation. But God, amen, is going to show he's overplayed his hand and he never wins and he's not going to win here. And God's going to do a work, and we're going to get to see this work that he's doing. Praise God, and we're going to be a part of it. In Psalms 85, verse 6, the psalmist says this in this verse of Scripture, Will thou not revive us again? Will you not revive us again, that your people may rejoice in you? Hallelujah. Is that your heart's prayer today? Yes. You look up to God and say, God, revive us again. I don't know about you, and I'm thankful for what's happened here since the beginning of the first of the year. We're experiencing excitement. We're experiencing some momentum. We're experiencing some good things, some growth, and new people are coming, amen, and experiencing the presence of God. But I just want you to know that that's just the beginning. And my prayer is, God, revive us. Amen, revive us. Praise God, revive us. Revive our hearts. Revive us that we may be able to rejoice in you. The Bible says the joy of the Lord is our strength. I want to see you joyful. Praise God. I look at you and you're frowning. Somebody you're frowning at me. Like you're mad at me. I want you to come in the house of God smiling. Praise God. Joy unspeakable and full of glory. Praise God. Would you pray that God would just speak to us today? Father, we love you and we thank you. God, you're a good God. And you want to speak to your people. And I pray, God, that you'll anoint me today, God. I pray that you will speak through me today. And God, you anoint my lips to speak, and you anoint our hearts to hear and receive. Yes. And God will give you the praise for it in Jesus' wonderful name. Amen. And amen. Praise God. Praise God. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. Turn around, look at the one beside of you, and say, come on, smile. Come on, smile. Go ahead and smile. Praise God is good. You serve a good God. I'm just a little bit mad this morning that Uncle Aaron back there, I didn't get any snow. You know, I told you last week I trusted you and you told me we was going to get some snow. I told Suzanne, I said, that rascal, you told me to tell you. I know some people got it. You probably got it your way. I mean, it just did for some reason or another. I moved up farther north towards Bristol because I got tired of not getting in. Because anytime I was living here in Piney, it would always snow up there. Wouldn't snow here. So I told Susanna, I said, let's just move. We'll get up there a little closer, a little farther north, and we'll get some snow. And I'll be back going. It just evades me everywhere I'm at. I don't know what the deal is. Like that might be it. Praise God. But I believe with all my heart today, I know I showed you a little excerpt there. That was that not to, just to see that the just the pureness of an individual that's just experiencing God on a level that just words just couldn't express it. He was just trying to express greatness on the inside of him, and it was just coming out, and it was joy. And it's just what God does for you. He just baptizes you in joy and love and something special about what's going on in this move. You hear testimonies of it. It's not people shouting, running, and dancing. It's a contrite spirit. It's repentance. It's love. It's peace. Just settling in on people. Just the love of God and the peace of God and the comfort of God. Saying, I'm your Father and I've got you. And I'm upholding you with the right hand of my righteousness. And I'm going to do something in this day that's going to just make your head spin. And you're not going to believe it. You just keep trusting in me. Praise God.
Glory.
But God is up to something. I feel it in my soul. The songwriter says this in a song I heard. It's God is up to something. God is doing something right now. He's healing someone. He's saving someone. God is doing something right now. He's moving mountains and he's making a way for someone. God is doing something right now. I believe that without a shadow of doubt that God is truly up to something in this day. And like we've said here time and time again, and my prayer is every morning, I say, God, whatever you're going to do, please don't do it without me. Please don't leave me out. Please let me be a part of what you're going to do in this last day. I want to be there. I want to experience it. I want to see it.
Amen. Glory.
Psalms, Isaiah, rather 64, verse 1 says, oh, that you would rend the heavens, that you would come down, that the mountains might shake at your presence.
Yeah.
I was listening this week talking about this revival, and I thought it was so interesting to look back in the history of the way things go. And God, it's amazing to see that they've had four or five major outpourings there at Asbury University. The first one being in 1905. They had a great revival happen there on that campus. They had one in 1950. They had one in 1970. And then they're having one now. But in 1905, the great revival, the great move that they had, just following that, right after that great move of God, we had the Azusa Street breakout in 1906 in California. And God moved mightily in a special way. He moved from, started there and moved all across the United States and all over the world. The Spirit of God, the Pentecostal movement started there. It was amazing that there was a great outpouring first at this Asbury campus. In 1950, when they had the great outpouring, following the great outpouring was the healing revival with Oral Roberts and T.L. Lowry and all those that started the great tent ministries, and God started moving and healing people in just a magnificent and a mighty way. In 1970, they had a great move of God called the Jesus Movement. Some of you may remember that or may be a part of that. Come to Christ during that time. Here in just a couple of weeks, there's going to be a movie. Greg Laurie has put this movie, him and some other people. It's a great, looks like it's going to be an exciting, a great film to go see. Amen. At the movies, and it's going to be about his life and about the Jesus Movement. And the very, I can't think of the guy's name off the top of my head that come out of this Asbury revival. He's the one who went out, and you'll see him in the movie, but he was there at Asbury in 1970, was touched by God, and was so a part of that. So now, we see in 2023, we see God moving again. It's like telling you, if you just check back history, you see what's happened in the past. I'm just here to know that God is about to do something great across this land. God is about to move in a mighty and a spectacular way. Of His presence today. Oh God, Isaiah said that you would rend the heavens and that you would come down, that the mountains might shake at your presence. Great moves of God follow these movements. I said last week, we talked about a few weeks ago also about the Spirit of God, and it's not by mind, and it's not going to be by power, but it's going to be by His Spirit. Everything that happens in our land today, everything that we see going on in our churches, we must first understand that it must be Spirit-led.
Amen.
Yeah. It can't be drummed up by me. Wow. It can't be hyped up and then by stage and by music and lights and fog machines. But we have all of that. We see that going on in our world today. Our churches, we have all of the stuff. We've got all of the stuff. We've got the structure. We've got the buildings. We've got the instruments. We have the stage. We have all the things in this city that you need to put on the show. But what we've got to understand is we must have all that's good. And I'm not against any of it. But we must have the presence of God.
Yes.
We must know that we've got the presence of God. Without God being on it. Without His anointing. And without His touch. Praise God, it will not accomplish what it needs to accomplish. It may sound good, and you may like it, and you may enjoy it, but it won't change your life. But the presence of God will change your life. The presence of God will change
you. Glory to God.
Get ready. Get prepared. God is moving us. God is taking us somewhere.
Yes, glory.
Revival is here. Look at your neighbor and say, revival is here.
Revival
is here. Restoration is here.
Yes.
Healing is here.
Yes. Glory.
Who's going to experience it? Who's going to experience it? Hungry hearts. Hungry hearts are the ones that are going to receive it. And I'm going to ask you today, are you hungry? Or you like the psalmist saying, oh Lord, revive us. Oh God, please revive us. We can't do this without you. We've tried to drum it up. We've tried to make it happen. But God, we can't do it in our own power. We must have the fire of God upon our lives and our hearts today. You could sit on your hands this morning if you want to. You can be cynical today if you want to. It's already started. Online and other preachers and other people are just talking about and bad-mouthing what's going on and saying that it's not a move of God, that it's just a bunch of kids getting together wanting to get out of class for a while and not wanting to do their normal responsibilities and all these different things, and they're downplaying it. And you can have that type of attitude if you want. And I told you last week, you can be like Mikhail if you want to. David, not David's wife, but Saul's daughter. God never, ever called her David's wife. He just said Saul's daughter. She made fun of David and the way he was praising God. And her spirit, that same spirit's trying its best to make its way into our churches today, saying it don't take all of that. It don't take praising God. It doesn't take worship. It doesn't take falling down on your face before God and crying out to Him and worshiping Him because He's worthy of all of that. And that spirit tries to tell you that you can just sit there and be cynical, sit there and say, oh, I don't want to do it. I'd rather just be comfortable. I'd rather just sit here. How in the world can we just sit there when we know what God has done for us? How can we be quiet when we know how He reached His mighty hand? My question for you today is, how can we be silent? How can we be quiet? How can we just sit back and act like that it's just a few races and whatever it is. I like to watch golf. I get excited watching golf. Man, it's hard to get excited watching golf. But I still get excited watching. And I don't think there's anything wrong with any of that. But you just see, you look on the screen and you see these grown men that have no doubt that in their normal day lives are probably just like most of us. They get up every day. Some of them probably have normal jobs and do normal things. And man, they got their face painted. And they got these, some of them got their shirts off, got these costumes on. And got, just wild looking stuff. Watch the Super Bowl, you see some of those. I mean, they were fanatics, you know. And I mean, they get so excited and so worked up. And they jump up and they shout and they spin around. And they get, oh, when that ball's thrown, when somebody gets a first down, they get excited about it. And I just think of those same people. I hope that when they're in church on Sunday morning, when they think about Jesus and they think about His goodness, they think about His love, they think about how He saved you, how He helped you, how He redeemed us, all that He's done for us. How in the world can we not get excited? How can we not allow our grace to be super? How can we not lift our faith and shout unto God? Praise God with the voice of triumph. This is our moment. This is our time. It's our turn. It's our turn now. Look at your neighbor and say, it's your turn. It's your turn. You're up to bat. You know, I think about the ones, some of the great men that have gone on before us. I really don't know. The Bible says that we're surrounded with such a great cloud of witnesses. And I don't know if they're peering down on us today or not. Just wondering, I think about T.L. Lowry. I think about some of the great evangelists of our day and of our time. And how they look down and they may see us. And no doubt they're cheering us on and excited. But it's our turn now. You know, they had their day and they did great things. They did great exploits for God. And God used them in a powerful and a great way. Now think about us. We're up to bat. Just like I said earlier, we could have been born and lived at any time. But we're living now. We're living in this moment. We're living in this day. It's time for us to go step up to the plate and swing. Amen. Expect to hit a home run. And praise God. God's with you. God's for you. Story that goes along with that, I'll say this, and I'm closing with this, so I'll be done in just a few minutes, but it's a story, how many remember, I believe it was 1988, could have been 89, but it was a great series baseball game between, I think, the Dodgers and the Oakland A's were playing. And Kirk Gibson, it's one that you get to see all the time when Kirk Gibson comes up to the plate and both of his legs were destroyed. I mean, in the previous games, he blew one of his knees out and like his hamstring. So he was in bad shape. And so they were in the next game, and he was completely out. And he was off site somewhere being worked on, was not playing the game. And so Vince Scully was the announcer, and he made that statement. He said on TV, Kirk Gibson was getting worked out by the therapist on his legs and stuff, and he was watching the game while that was going on. And Vince Scully said, wonder where in the world Kirk Gibson is. And obviously he said, it looked like he's dressed out tonight. He probably won't be playing. And when Kirk Gibson heard that competitive fire stirred up, and he thought, what do you mean where am I? Where am I? He said, get me up off this table. Give me my uniform. So he put his uniform on, he made his way to wherever he was, close to the ballpark or whatever. He went marching in there. He looked at Tommy Lasorda and he said, I'm ready to go whenever you're ready. You put me in the pinch hit, whatever you need. And so Lasorda just, you know, I mean, Kirk Gibson was the man. He, you know, so he thought, well, if he says he's ready, then I believe he's ready. And so sure enough, got, you've all watched the replay of it. He gets up. I think Dennis Eckersley was pitching, great pitcher for the Oakland A's. And he takes a few pitches, fouls a couple off. And all of a sudden, just with the upper body swing, he had no legs. And he just reached out and smacks the ball. There it goes over the fence. Hits a home run. He hobbles. You see him running across the limp and all those different things. And so, guy asked Tom LaSorda, said, "What? How did you make that decision? What did you, what caused you to say, after you knew all that was wrong with him and all the different people you got that you could have chose to go in and hit during that moment that were healthy, that were strong, that were ready to go?" And all those guys are professional athletes, you know, so they're all capable of doing great things. If you're at that level, you can do great things at any time, you know? But Tom LaSorda just said, "I just knew it was his time. I just felt like it was his time." You know, and I thought, don't let the guys, the witnesses that are up above us, be looking around and saying, "I wonder where Mike's at. I wonder where Ted is. I wonder where Charles is. Where is he? Where is he?" Because it's his turn. It's your turn. It's our turn. Revival's here. Revival's now. Praise God. Restoration is here. It's our turn. Praise God. Hallelujah. Let's step up to the plate. Let's do what we've been called to do because God is with us.
Glory.
Don't miss this moment. Jesus, as you're standing with me, Jesus made a statement. He said in Luke chapter 19, he wept, the Bible said. Wept. He looked over Jerusalem and wept. And he said, I was right here among you. And you missed your hour. You missed your day of visitation. You missed it. The religious people couldn't grasp him. They couldn't grasp a carpenter's son born out of wedlock, born of a virgin. The story that was told of his birth. And so you can imagine, we all know and just understand that you think of all somebody coming up with that story. Such a story there. It's amazing when you read that story and you start thinking about the reality of it all, how what people must have thought, because we all know how people are. And they missed him. He said, "No way, this is just the carpenter's son." It couldn't be the Messiah. It couldn't be the one we've been looking for. And I thought many times how God wants to move in our lives, and we wrap it up in some type of box and say, "It's supposed to be like this." And we might miss him. Because we expect him to come in a different package. God's moving. God's moving. I want him to move in me. I want him to move over you. I want him to move in this community. In Piney Flats, I want the Tri-Cities Church of God to be a portal of his glory, of his presence. People like Nikolai will drive by and go, "I need to go to church today. I don't know why. I don't know. Bunch of white people in there. I don't know what they're thinking. I don't know." But all he felt was something drawing him. And what a blessing. Man, he's been to our church. What a blessing. I hope to meet you to him. I'm so thankful that God's doing it. He gets up and he's singing and God's using him. And he got up and read a scripture last Wednesday night when he sung right before he sung. And I looked over at Mom and I said, "Won't be long that boy be preaching. He'll be preaching." He's going to be preaching before long. He's getting on him. or start out singing, come up here quiet, don't say anything, all of a sudden there's something, starts with Holy Ghost gets on you, and God, I've got to say something, I've got to read scripture. And then you'll have to start talking about it, and amen, praise God, it goes on from there. But God's doing great things, God's moving in people's lives. We're so excited about it. God wants to do that in you. One more verse of scripture that I want to say to you this morning in Hosea chapter 10, verse 12 says, sow for yourselves righteousness, reap in mercy, break out your fallow ground, for it is time to seek the Lord, till He comes and rains righteousness on you. These 3 points I'll leave you with this morning. We need to seek the Lord. We need to seek Him in repentance. We need to seek Him in restoration. Our hearts must be broken for the lost. Think about how God restored you and how He met you where you are. Somebody, somewhere was praying for you. Somebody was calling out your name in prayer. Someone was travailing for you. We must become that someone and start praying for this generation. Seek Him in restoration. And the last thing is seek Him for revival. Seek Him for revival. We're up to bat. This is our generation. These kids are our kids. The government will not save them. School teachers and schools will not lead them. God, we need you. We need revival. We need your presence. We need your glory. Then we will not have this generation. You will not have this generation. You will not have our young people in the Tri-Cities. Johnson City, Bristol, Kingsport, Elizabeth. You will not have our children. Because we're going to stand in the gap. He placed us here at this moment because He had faith in you that you'd get it done. He had faith in you that you'd get it done. And I believe we're going to get it done. So I'm going to ask you this morning to hit these altars. And let's begin to pray like it depends on your prayer. Like all the cards are in your hand. It might be your prayer that saves your son or your daughter or whatever you're believing God for. It might be your cry this morning. But when we come before God, that's how we need to come before Him. Like, if I don't pray, then it might not happen. Let the weightiness of that fall on you. Spirit of intercession, fall on us. It's our turn. We're up to bat. I think all the time, just of an example of, as a young child, moving here, coming in this area, and the church, Tri-City Church of God at that time, was in a little storefront building. Some of you still remember that place where we were at. There's nothing elaborate about that place at all. It was rough. It was rough. And I think to myself, Carolyn, Charles, Fred, and Donna.
God was there.
Amen.
And God was there. I think about how tough that was. You know, I think about what we get to come in here today to. And you say, look what the Lord's done. You know, these seats are not, they're not super comfortable. I know that. I know that they get hard after a while. I get to sit in them too. But if you could just think where we come from, look where we're at now. But I just think about the price that was paid. Somebody paid a price and was uncomfortable and was cold on Sunday mornings and was hot in the summertime, cold in the winter, and it smelled like kerosene in the room, and you didn't know whether you were catching a buzz off of that or if it was the Holy Spirit getting on you. And all you knew is that you were feeling a little woozy, praise God, and it may have been the kerosene. But today we don't have any of that. Somebody paid the price. Somebody stuck it out. Because it was their turn. Brother Hubert Sams and Sister Ina Wissenhunt. And I start calling names. I forget Linda and Linda Honeycutt. All those that we remember that paid that price. I'm so thankful that they did it. It was their turn. But guess what? Now it's our turn.
Yes.
So let's not be lazy during our turn. But let's be intercessors. And let's pray. So I'm going to invite you to this altar this morning. As they sing, I just want you to come as close as you can. Kneel if you want to. Stand. Just make a move close. And let's call out to God. Let's pray. Let's pray. Let's pray for the lost people in our area. Let's pray for those that are addicted to drugs. Those that are addicted to alcohol, those that are in bondage today to depression and anxiety, those that are caught up in pornography, those that are caught up in perversion. Let's pray that God will bring deliverance to their lives. Hallelujah, bring deliverance to their lives. It's our turn, God. Lord, do it.